Hey guys, Rolia or Taylor here, and today I'm back with another Division video. And in this one, we've got another special State of the Game recap. Today we're going to be looking at Commendations in more detail to any other video that I've done on this channel. But first up, I am just going to go through the State of the Game as normal and go over some of the fixes that were mentioned, as well as some PTS news. So first up, we have confirmation that the PTS will be coming to all three platforms. That includes PC, Xbox One and PS4. So there you go, console players, rejoice. You're now going to be able to go hands-on with the PTS as soon as it drops. Unfortunately, we don't have a date yet, but I will keep you up to date as soon as we do. There's also a bug fix for the recovery link where the auto revive feature would still work while other signature skills were still on cooldown. And they've also created an out of bounds area inside Midtown Music that will prevent players from staying inside the environment. A more permanent fix will be deployed down the line, but at the moment, this is just to stop you from doing it. And last but not least, we're going to have a weekend event starting tomorrow. Now all drops from named bosses are going to be increased, and that includes every named boss. This starts from tomorrow and ends on the 19th. Right, now let's have a look at commendations. So what is a commendation? Commendations are an in-game achievement that once unlocked will reward you with a commendation score, and some of the harder ones will actually reward you with a new vanity item. Now at first I didn't know if I could speak about this vanity item, but now I can. They're going to be arm patches and they're going to replace the SHD logo on the right shoulder of your agent. So at the moment you can see there's 8 different types of commendations. We have general, combat, missions, exploration, PvP, DLC, global events, and achievements. Achievements are actually the ones that come with the game. So for example, the ones that give you gamer score for Xbox, for example, or for PS4, they give you trophies. That's what the achievement ones are. So commendations are tied to the actual game achievements. I said achievements so much, but I think you know what I mean. So once you select the commendation category, you are then given a list of commendations you can complete and how to complete them. So as you can see here, Gabe's account, who is actually playing this, has already completed the final curtain, which is uncover the fears of Gordon Amherst and Aaron Keener. On the level, which is reach level 30 with an agent, and Bling Bling equipped all equipment slots with superior or high-end items. The little medal icon is the ones that are tied to actual game achievements, and the little Uplay ones are the ones that are tied to Uplay achievements that were already within the game. And as you can see, just below the Bling Bling commendation, we have Bank of New York, which is about a quarter of the way through, which is have acquired 5 million credits. And this is actually a tiered commendation. So there's 6 tiers to this commendation, and you'll only get your commendation score and possible patch once you've completed all 6 tiers. Now I say possible patch because we don't know which ones will give you patches and which ones will give you just a commendation score. A commendation score is more of a bragging rights thing than anything else. It's not like gear score or anything like that, it doesn't affect your gear. Commendation score is acquired once you've unlocked a commendation. Some of these might give you 5 commendation score, some might give you 50. Obviously, the harder the commendation, the more commendation score you're going to get once you unlock it. Commendations will carry over to different characters, so if you unlock something on a different character and go back to your main, you're going to have that commendation that you unlocked on your main character. So they will cross over to a certain extent. So some better examples for commendations, not the ones that are already tied to achievements or Uplay activities. These ones are fully from the Division themselves. Now luckily enough, I was at ETF, like I've probably said too many times, but I went through a massive spreadsheet and heard some of the really cool and crazy commendations they're going to try and put into the game. But Hamish on stream mentioned a couple that are very interesting indeed. One, for example, was complete a legendary mission without wiping or going down at all. Another one was complete Dragon's Nest without being hit by an RC car. Now like I said, that's only a couple. In the game, there's going to be hundreds of these, but in stream, they were on a development build, so it only showed 110, but I think I'm right in saying that that's going to be a lot more than that. That about wraps it up for this video, guys. As always, I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoyed the first look at commendations and a peek at something else that's coming in 1.7. As always, guys, if you enjoyed this video, then let me know by either clicking that like button or by commenting down below. And if you're new around here and want to stay up to date with the Division, then make sure you subscribe. But as always, I'll see you all soon. Bye-bye.